Well, hey, you know, this is an opening sort of a debut for these guys. I have to tell you some stories because Jared and Katrina I've known for years and years. I like to say that I was part of bringing Katrina into the bluegrass music part. She was, I'll never forget walking in her grandfather's house. We were doing something in the basement and there was a guitar there, and I picked the guitar up and started playing it. Oh, I think it was at Mark's house. He said something about a banjo, and I said, well, Debbie bought me one. It's not a really good one. He said, well, Katrina's been wanting to learn how to play a banjo. So he was working on a tractor of mine, and I walked down the basement, and I had this, or in his garage, which his garage was under the house, and I had this banjo, and I only know a couple of things on a banjo, and I was whacking away on it, and all of a sudden, here come Katrina running down. Who's playing banjo? I said, you are now, because here, I'm going to give this to you, because you want to, but she took it from there. She took lessons on banjo, she took lessons on mandolin, but she's now a really good bass player. She plays a lot of different stuff. And Jared is just unbelievable as far as his talent. He goes on and on. But I'm glad you guys are here. I'm glad that they chose this place to open up. And it's just a blessing to me. It's something that I really enjoy. But you know, I always open, if you've never been here before, I never do a show in here or any kind of jam session that we don't open up with a word of prayer. So if you gentlemen would remove your hats and let's have a word of prayer. Father God, we just thank you so much for this wonderful day that you've given us to celebrate. Lord, we always do everything to worship you. Father, we have fun here and we have fellowship, we have food, and we just have a bunch of friends. And Father, we just thank you so much for this wonderful turnout. And it gives me just great pleasure to host these kids. And I just ask you to continue to bless their talents, Lord, to give them everything that they need to continue on with their future in music. Amen. All right. Amen. I'm going to ask you, tell them to get ready. I'm going to ask you guys to make these guys welcome. For the first time as a group on stage, the Allegheny Turnaround. So let's make them welcome. Woo! So they said, no, hey, listen, while I got you, I'm going to do an advertisement. I'm going to do it. If you've never seen that lady over there, then you've not, you've never been around, because she shows up everywhere. But her and Dale, she puts on a Patsy Cline show. It's unbelievable. She did it here a couple of times. She's been looking at country here. She's done. But they're having a thing at the Capitol Theater in Chambersburg. And it's on March the 11th. And I encourage you guys to go see this. They do a wonderful show. It's just, they've done so much in all over the area, and it's just wonderful to have. But if you want one of these flyers, so you don't forget, you put it on your refrigerator, they're going to be sitting right back here where my wife is. And are you guys ready yet?
No, I don't think, not yet. We're getting there. We got a room full of women back.
So anyway, now don't forget, the first Saturday of every month, we have nothing but gospel. If you like gospel music, this is the place to be. Am I right, guys?
Yeah.
It's been here for gospel. It's a wonderful place to play gospel. There's everything from bluegrass gospel to contemporary gospel to southern gospel to good old hymns. It's just unbelievable what you'll hear here. On second and fourth Saturdays of the month, we have nothing but country. So just next month, on the 18th, we will have Copper Canyon here. So they're going to be here. All right, one more time. Make a great welcome.
Yeah.
There's a young man that I know is there just one. it's nice to play for people instead of standing in our dining room, sitting to nobody but the dog.
So,
no, she didn't say nothing. That's right. Hopefully, y'all would have said something. All right, we're going to do an old Stanley Brothers tune now. I'm just going to kick it off. It's called A Little Bit of Time.
Spring on sunny days, I'm traveling free, 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 free
maybe it'd be nice. We'll do that. Not the oldest, that part? Maybe. Either way, we'll get the fiddle player. Not only does he play a good fiddle, he sings pretty good too. So would y'all make welcome Evan Blankenstedt.
Yeah, brother, won't be rocking long.
we got certain people that's thankful that have come, at least I do, bring us in that way of life. And I guess the first one would be my grandfather. He loved bluegrass music and gospel music. And one of my first songs I probably ever heard was Rita and Smiley, which really got me into this type of music. And we're going to do this one in honor of my grandfather, because I'm using my Bible for a roadmap.
Love me, darling. something. I'm too dry to say this. So.
You said something. You said something. Robbie, he wants to sit in my
stomach.
All right, I guess you're probably wondering where we got the name of Allegheny Turnaround. And that is, these two live on one side, we live on the other, and we meet in the middle to practice, and we just leave the turnaround. So, it came pretty simple, not much thought, nothing unusual. But we'll slow it down a little bit here and do an old Demetri song called Queen Anne's Lace. After Devin gets his water.
Thank you.
many people as I've been in this music. And I guess this guy was like a second grandfather to me, I'm sure. So you know, Red Shingleton from Clear Spring, Maryland. I spent many times in his house. I've gotten in trouble with my wife at his house.
Mama's gonna pick me up at the hospital after having Caroline. Oh, because he's at his house.
At his house, I walked into his house and let him know that our second child was born, and he told me to commit for a minute. There was never a minute with Red. 3 hours later, I told him I have to go, and he asked me, she's in the hospital, ain't she? Yes. Well, she'll be there when you get there. So, I'm going to dedicate this song to him. Every time you would go visit, he would sing this song.
Is he still married?
He was. Believe it or not. This song all reminds me of him, and every time we would get together, he would sing this song. It's called Love at the Mountains. This was dedicated to Red Shingleton.
this is a...
Thanks,
Love.
somebody be in shock, killed, everything like that. It's all movement. Unfortunately, most of it was written over a true happening that happened long ago. This one, I don't know if it did or not. I'm going to act like it did. And it also falls in this bluegrass category. Bluegrass. Got some scary things. I'm going to leave you on this one. It's called Eli Renfro.